In this video, we will be exploring Ella. The first thing we noticed is how touristic it is here compared to the north of Sri Lanka. However, it is much fresher and the landscapes are breathtaking. Hiking is now on the list of the best thing to do with Ella Rock and Little Adam's Peak, as well as continuing discovering the famous blue train of Sri Lanka with 9 art bridges. As Ella is quite developed for tourists, we will this time be trying more international restaurants. So let's get to it. Alright, and here we are in Ella. I booked an accommodation a bit outside of town to have a really great view from the room. But apparently I didn't book the right room, so that's on me, that's my bad. So we got a room that doesn't have like a really nice view, but still over a little forest, so it's not too bad. And we get our own little cabin with a viewpoint. With lounge chair, here is our forest view. We also have 2 more lounge chairs in the dining area, also only for us. And here is the room. Here is Tina stretching. There are 2 double beds, but we'll use the one downstairs. It's not gonna be less warm. So there is no AC in that room, but so far last night with only the fan, it was fine. It's a bit colder at night here in Ella than anywhere else. So those are the chipmunks.
I think.
I think so too.
I can ask, but...
After a delicious breakfast with a view, it was time to hike up to the rail track to reach the Ella Rock trailhead. Alright, so first day in Ella. And the adventure starts with a little hike to Ella Rock.
Not really little, it's 4 hours.
One way apparently, 2 hours back. And what's original with that hike is that the first part, that where we are right now, it's actually on train tracks. And those are active, so it's super cool. And well, gratefully there isn't that many trains here. There aren't that many trains, so yeah. For now, all good. Let's see on all trails a little bit further, and then we'll reach and start the second part of the trail, which is going up apparently, so
through the forest.
Through the forest. We need to mention that also our host told us that actually along the way you will find locals that will tell you that Ella Rock is that way or this way or through there, but they are kind of scam, like just to make you go somewhere and then in the end make you pay. He said the same, that sometimes you have people, they say, oh, they are guide, and then you take them on the way, and then they bring you somewhere and they just ask money. So the best is, to try to follow like the train track, and then he showed us the way approximately on all trails, and we are recording it now, so we'll also share that with you. All right, first train station. And it's after that normally that we go inside the forest. Yeah. So should be here on the left. Well, there is no indication at all. But yeah, that's it. Yeah, I guess when you see the rice paddy and an opening, that goes straight backward, but you just turn. And then there is a little bridge normally.
Yes.
And yeah. So that's it.
Those are the indication that you're on the right way. Okay, so we just got a bit lost, passed by someone's property, but okay, found a trail, so we'll follow it. So if you have old trails or a map download, do follow it. You kind of follow like a nicer path than what it looks like on the old trail, and then we follow other people. But I was completely wrong. Then we got a bit lost, passed by a few property. The guy that already wanted to show us around, so
it was the wrong way.
Yeah, so stick to the map. Right, so here is the sign to follow, and the map agrees. Apart from that little portion that we missed. Yeah, that board I saw online like made a lot of people frustrated because foreigner pay more than 10 times more than local for. What? But
yeah, it's okay.
Yeah. Yeah. It's fine now. 930. It's what, like €3 per person.
I mean, it's a lot for them.
It's a lot for them, and for us, yeah. No, it's good. At least you contribute a bit to economy. After all, tourism is one of their. Main income, so bushy. What's up? Almost at the checkpoint or ticket office, I don't know how they call it. And definitely that last part was a bit hard. Wow.
Yeah, I had one time he almost dropped my
head. Right, on to the next viewpoint. Well, when we arrived at Ella Rock, it was beautiful and all empty.
You were the only one.
Yeah, but only for maybe what, 5 minutes, 10?
No, it's fine, we had and, our yeah. time.
And then, well, a bunch of people came. But it was really nice, so the hike was fine. The last part through it's a bit hard, but it's mostly because of the heat.
It's worth it.
Yeah. Even the entrance fee, it's actually worth it as it seems like they are building actually things around, so
they are using our money
yes.
wisely.
Yeah, to improve a bit, like they are making fences, there are toilets also available, they are building bench. Here they are building kind of A-frame. They build an A-frame, I don't know what it's for, but maybe a guest house at some point. Super nice. And now we are going to the second viewpoint. White flag. And now we are on our way back. The second viewpoint.
Was lovely.
Yeah. Dina found the perfect spot under a tree on the edge of the cliff.
With the view.
With the view.
And we stayed there for maybe already, what, 30 minutes?
Yeah, I would say so. It was really enjoyable. And well, now we are slowly walking back. And they have washroom. So there were no running water. In the toilet, and now it's the way down. Yeah, can we get to? Coconut cheers. How was that coconut?
Mm.
We got the coconut.
Refreshing.
Really nice. Really big, actually. There was lots of.
Well,
coconut water inside.
It looks small,
yeah.
But it's full of water.
And it costs only $3.50 per coconut. Achoo!
Oba!
Sorry. So we would definitely recommend to stop at Shashika Viewpoint Juice Bar. that so far has, well, 5 stars on Google, we didn't know, for 327 reviews, boy. Well, and the coconut was really good. So after the bridge, go left, not right. Well, that was a bit scary. Whoa.
Oh my God.
Whoa. Well, I didn't see that one coming. Oh boy. Well, I was thinking that like the train would only be like, the train passing here would be the same as the 9-hour bridges, but nobody mentioned that one. Boy. Whoa. Well, so, well, there can be train anytime. And it's good that there is a bit of space to get really on the side, but it's tight.
After all that, we went back to our accommodation and then headed to town for lunch. Once our tummy full, we strolled around town, checked a few stores and then went for an ice cream.
Homemade island coconut ice cream.
We then took a tuk-tuk for the 9-hour bridge.
Tell us about your experience with the 9-hour bridge.
Well, it was crowded and sunny.
Yeah.
Very hot.
Yeah, we went there at 4:10 something. Yeah, 10 past 4 basically we were there. We didn't think that actually today is Sunday. And, well, the bridge was packed actually with a school, lots of locals, obviously a few foreigners too. So it wasn't a great time. We're also looking to take a few shots on the side of the bridge, but on the upper side it was actually not that good because the sun would go directly on us and then
the lights were not on our
feet. Yeah, the lights weren't good and well, the picture looks like nothing actually. So Sunday afternoon, not a good time to go there. Definitely, wouldn't recommend it.
Maybe now at 5:30, last train would be better.
Yeah, because now yeah, the sun is down, so at least the light is good. Would be much better. We got lucky because the 4:30 train passed at what, 4:50 maybe? Something like that. There was a train, it came, it actually even stopped on the bridge for 10 minutes and then continue. So yeah, we could get a few nice shots of that, but on the side of the bridge no, we couldn't, and on the bridge obviously was impossible because there were hundreds of people. So we asked our tuk-tuk actually, the driver, he was really nice actually, he brought us even to Ansanka Cafe. And he said that maybe in the morning would be way better, so you don't have train. He said 7 p.m. it's really good.
We'll see.
We'll see, yeah. Maybe we'll go back tomorrow. But I don't think for 7 p.m. Maybe after breakfast for maybe 8:30 or 9. Could be nice too. And final word. as we had a late lunch. Well, we just buy a few snacks. We just bought a few snacks and are heading home for the night. Take a nice shower and rest. Because Ella Rock was in the end a bit challenging. Let's do it.
Zemba.
So, dinner, 2 beers, cassava chips, baked peanut,
and brine crackers. Pop it, party time! The next morning, we woke up to a beautiful weather. And to well start the day, had a delicious breakfast. Today, we will be back at the Nine Art Bridges and then go to the Little Adam's Peak.
He's chasing the bird.
So this morning we are having a lot of babies in our room.
So that was the baby lizard, but the
well, baby chipmunk.
Exciting thing and a scary thing at the same time is that there was a chipmunk mother like on the ceiling with a baby, and I don't know what happened, but the baby fell or she dropped him, and super scared. We thought like he got injured, but he stood up and then ran away, and well, now he's somewhere around the room hiding. He seems to be really scared. So we are packing, and then yeah, hopefully she will come pick him up. But so far, well, we don't know where she disappeared. Well, so the baby chipmunk now is hiding behind the toilet. Told our host, he said that apparently he can just take him and then put him outside. And now we can hear his mother, she's also looking for him. So hopefully they will be reunited soon. Some more information about the tuk-tuk. There are two entry points with tuk-tuk to the Nine Art Bridge. One is 2.5 km from the city. The other, it's twice more or three times more, and that brings you on the other side of the bridge, and for that one it's 4,000 after your accommodation could arrange it for cheaper. The guy in our place could actually do it 3,500 rupees from our accommodation to the Nine Art Bridge to the Little Adam's Peak and then back. So yeah, because the best is to always ask your accommodation for it. Well, quick recommendation, if you are on the Nine Art Bridge, do go down in the little tea plantation there. They are basically nobody. All the people are mostly like staying all the way up, and you can take beautiful picture all alone with the bridge. And we got lucky because this is our second time here, and there was also again a train. So it was a bit crowded on top, now the train passed. Let's see how it looks. All right, let's start Little Adam's Peak. Ah, that's where they said to go after, right? That 98 acre.
Oh, they went just for a drink.
Yeah, go for a drink, a bit in the pool. Tina, what's your recommendation for Ella? Ah, here is a zip line. So the recommendation for Ella was?
To get accommodation with swimming pool.
Yeah, because even if the morning are fresh, they are still super hot.
So in the morning you can go for some of the hikes, and then you come back, you have nice lunch, and you stay by swimming pool until evening, and then in the evening you go for dinner, and it's just perfect.
Yeah, that would have been lovely to know.
On the
on our way back from Little Adam's Peak.
Mini Adam's Peak.
Well, there were a couple of viewpoints up there. It was okay. Took what, maybe 25 minutes, half an hour maybe to go up there. 15 to go back. Definitely much more touristy than Ella Rocks. There are lots of people and tons of group coming here. The entrance is free though, so that's cool. And you have toilet up there, but after the whole complex, it's like really made for tourists. Like, you have zip line, you have a swing, you have you are next to a huge resort, so if you want to enjoy after that, and if you don't have pool where you are staying, well, you could go to that resort, have a drink and enjoy their pool. Something else to say?
That's it.
Let's go there, in the corner, yeah. Over there, there is someone, so... Martina, you have a friend now. Behind you. It's a cat, not a monkey. Cheers. Oh, I love gelato. I mean, best ice cream in town and room with AC. And comfortable sofas. Final rail track walk. Final moment with this view passage. A good alternative to the tuk-tuk hustle would be to actually rent a scooter here in Ella. It costs 2,500 rupees per day and could be really convenient actually, and much cheaper if you plan on moving around.
New experience, the local bathroom and toilet.
On to the next adventure towards Tisa Yala National Park, and in a minivan. Let's see that. So we almost missed the Ravana Falls. Our driver almost passed by. So
thankfully, we have Tina.
I'm too kind to say anything.
Oh, so I am not kind?
No, but for you it's fine if you sit, you know. Well, 25 meter. Danger, avoid bathing. Total depth 36, so you don't swim in those.
And if you want to save time planning your trip to Sri Lanka and later travel worry-free, we created a digital map with over 200 pins, including things to do, restaurants, accommodations, points of interest, trails, routes, and so much more. With this map, you will have all the information you need to travel in Sri Lanka. And guess what? It works on Android or Apple phones as well as PCs. In bonus, you get lifetime access as well as all the future updates. So if you want to know more about our Sri Lanka travel map, we put a link in the description.